Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to part 3 of our tutorial series about using JSON data in After Effects. In the previous parts of this series, we linked text and colors of the project to a JSON file. Now we also want to let the icons in this area appear or disappear based on the data in the JSON file. The icons are contained in this pre-comp here. If we open it, you can see that we have three icons: cloud, rain, and sun, that we can show or hide as needed. Since the links to the JSON document are always created with expressions and the layer eyeball does not support expressions, we have to control the visibility of the layers using their opacity. So we make sure the eyeball is enabled for all of them and then reveal their opacity properties. We select the opacity of the cloud layer and connect it with mamoworldJSON using the name icon.cloud. Then we connect the opacity of the rain layer to icon.rain and the one of the sun to icon.sun. In the mamoworld.json file, we now have the section icon with three values: cloud, rain, and sun. All of them are set to 100 since their opacity is 100%. If we want the sun to disappear, we can set the value to 0, and the opacity of the layer in After Effects changes accordingly. Now this is great, but setting a value to 0 or 100 might be a little counterintuitive to say that something should be shown or hidden. Therefore, mamoworldJSON also supports special keywords. So we can simply enter show for clouds and sun and hide for rain. And as you can see, now the rain is hidden and the clouds and sun are shown. Instead of show and hide, you can also use yes and no, true and false, or enabled and disabled. When reading the JSON data, mamoworldJSON looks for all of those keywords, and if it finds them, it replaces them by 100 and 0, respectively. So that's how easy it is to control the visibility of layers to a JSON document. Just link their opacity to the JSON document using mamoworldJSON, and then use the keywords to turn the layers on or off. In the next part of our series, we take a look under the hood of mamoworldJSON and learn how to adjust the link expressions it generates. This will serve the basis for endless customization options. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk from mamoworld.com. See you next time.